Jenny Stein, Wikipedia Audio. Jenny Stein is an isoflavone that is described as an angiogenesis inhibitor and a phytoestrogen. It was first isolated in 1899 from the Dyer's broom, Genista tincture toria, hence, the chemical name. The compound structure was established in 1926, when it was found to be identical with that of pruntal. It was chemically synthesized in 1928. Isoflavones such as Jenny Stein and Daidzein are found in a number of plants including lupin, fava beans, soybeans, kudzu, and cerealia being the primary food source, also in the medicinal plants, Flamingia vestida, and F. macrophylla, and coffee. It can also be found in Machia amorensis cell cultures. Most of the isoflavones in plants are present in a glycosylated form. The unglycosylated aglycones can be obtained through various means such as treatment with the enzyme beta-glucosidase, acid treatment of soybeans followed by solvent extraction, or by chemical synthesis. Acid treatment is a harsh method as concentrated inorganic acids are used. Both enzyme treatment and chemical synthesis are costly. A more economical process consisting of fermentation for in situ production of beta-glucosidase to isolate Jenny Stein has been recently investigated. Natural occurrences. Besides functioning as antioxidant and anthelmintic, many isoflavones have been shown to interact with animal and human estrogen receptors, causing effects in the body similar to those caused by the hormone estrogen. Isoflavones also produce non-hormonal effects. Jenny Stein influences multiple biochemical functions in living cells. Full agonist of OR and, to a much lesser extent, full agonist or partial agonist of OR, agonist of GPER, activation of peroxisome proliferator activated receptors, inhibition of several tyrosine kinases, inhibition of topoisomerase, inhibition of AAAD, direct antioxidation with some peroxidative features, activation of NRF2 antioxidative response, stimulation of autophagy, inhibition of the mammalian hexose transporter GLUT1, contraction of several types of smooth muscles, modulation of CFTR channel, potentiating its opening at low concentration and inhibiting it at higher doses, inhibition of cytosine methylation, inhibition of DNA methyltransferase, inhibition of the glycine receptor, inhibition of the nicotinic acetylcholine receptor. Isoflavones Jenny Stein and Daidzein bind to and transactivate all three PPAR isoforms, alpha, delta, and gamma. For example, membrane-bound PAR binding assay showed that Jenny Stein can directly interact with the PAR ligand binding domain and has a measurable key of 5.7 mm. Gene reporter assays showed that Jenny Stein at concentrations between 1 and 100 activated PPARs in a dose-dependent way in Ks483 mesenchymal progenitor cells, breast cancer MCF7 cells, T47D cells, and MDAMD231 cells, murine macrophage-like Ra264.7 cells, endothelial cells, and inhela cells. Several studies have shown that both ERS and PPARs influenced each other and therefore induced differential effects in a dose-dependent way. The final biological effects of Jenny Stein are determined by the balance among these pleiotrophic actions. The main known activity of Jenny Stein is tyrosine kinase inhibitor, mostly of epidermal growth factor receptor. Tyrosine kinases are less widespread than their CER/THR counterparts but implicated in almost all cell growth and proliferation signal cascades. Genistein may act as direct antioxidant, similar to many other isoflavones, and thus may alleviate damaging effects of free radicals in tissues. The same molecule of genistein, similar to many other isoflavones, by generation of free radicals poison topoisomerase II, an enzyme important for maintaining DNA stability. Human cells turn on beneficial, detoxifying NRF2 factor in response to genistein insult. This pathway may be responsible for observed health maintaining properties of small doses of genistein. The root tuber peel extract of the leguminous plant Phelmingia vestida is the traditional anthelmintic of the Kasai tribes of India. While investigating its anthelmintic activity, genistein was found to be the major isoflavone responsible for the deworming property. Genistein was subsequently demonstrated to be highly effective against intestinal parasites such as the poultry cestode Raelatina echinobothrida, the pork trematode Phaseolopsis buski, and the sheep liver fluke Phaseola hepatica. It exerts its anthelmintic activity by inhibiting the enzymes of glycolysis and glycogenolysis, and disturbing the Ca2+ homeostasis and no activity in the parasites. It has also been investigated in human tapeworms such as Echinococcus multilocularis and E. granulosis metacestodes that genistein and its derivatives, RM6423 and RM6426, are potent cesticides. Genistein protects against pro-inflammatory factor-induced vascular endothelial barrier dysfunction and inhibits leukocyte-endothelium interaction, thereby modulating vascular inflammation, a major event in the pathogenesis of atherosclerosis. Extraction and purification. Genistein and other isoflavones have been identified as angiogenesis inhibitors, and found to inhibit the uncontrolled cell growth of cancer, most likely by inhibiting the activity of substances in the body that regulate cell division and cell survival. Various studies have found that moderate doses of genistein have inhibitory effects on cancers of the prostate, cervix, brain, breast, and colon. It has also been shown that genistein makes some cells more sensitive to radiotherapy, although timing of phytoestrogen use is also important. Genistein's chief method of activity is as a tyrosine kinase inhibitor. Tyrosine kinases are less widespread than their SIR/THR counterparts but implicated in almost all cell growth and proliferation signal cascades. Inhibition of DNA topoisomerase II also plays an important role in the cytotoxic activity of genistein. The observation that transition of normal lymphocytes from quiescence to the G1 phase of the cell cycle is particularly sensitive to genistein prompted the authors to suggest that this isoflavone may be potential immunosuppressant. Genistein has been used to selectively target pre-B cells via conjugation with an anti-CD19 antibody. Studies on rodents have found genistein to be useful in the treatment of leukemia, and that it can be used in combination with certain other anti-leukemic drugs to improve their efficacy. Due to its structure similarity to 1,7-beta-estradiol, genistein can compete with it and bind to estrogen receptors. However, genistein shows much higher affinity toward estrogen receptor beta than toward estrogen receptor alpha. Data from in vitro and in vivo research confirms that genistein can increase rate of growth of some ER-expressing breast cancers. Genistein was found to increase the rate of proliferation of estrogen-dependent breast cancer when not co-treated with an estrogen antagonist. It was also found to decrease efficiency of tamoxifen and letrozole, drugs commonly used in breast cancer therapy. Genistein was found to inhibit immune response towards cancer cells, allowing their survival. Isoflavones can act like estrogen, stimulating development and maintenance of female characteristics, or they can block cells from using cousins of estrogen. In vitro studies have shown genistein to induce apoptosis of testicular cells at certain levels, thus raising concerns about effects it could have on male fertility. However, a recent study found that isoflavones had no observable effect on endocrine measurements, testicular volume, or semen parameters over the study period. In healthy males given isoflavone supplements daily over a 2-month period, genistein was, among other flavonoids, found to be a strong topoisomerase inhibitor, similarly to some chemotherapeutic anti-cancer drugs exetoposide and doxorubicin. In high doses it was found to be strongly toxic to normal cells. This effect may be responsible for both anticarcinogenic and carcinogenic potential of the substance. It was found to deteriorate DNA of cultured blood stem cells, which may lead to leukemia. Genistein, among other flavonoids, is suspected to increase risk of infant leukemia when consumed during pregnancy. Biological effects. Molecular function. Genistein decreases pathological accumulation of glycosaminoglycans in Sanfilippo syndrome. In vitro animal studies and clinical experiments suggest that the symptoms of the disease may be alleviated by adequate dose of genistein. Genistein was found to also possess toxic properties toward brain cells. Among many pathways stimulated by genistein, autophagy may explain the observed efficiency of the substance, as autophagy is significantly impaired in the disease. Activation of PPARs. Tyrosine kinase inhibitor. Redox active not only antioxidant. Anthelmintic. Atherosclerosis. Cancer links. Estrogen receptor more cancer links. Effects in males. Carcinogenic and toxic potential. Sanfilippo syndrome treatment. Related compounds.